Hello, my name is Rickard, and in this short tutorial, I want to show you three ways to do film grain in Photoshop. All right, the first method is under your filters, artistic, film grain. Now, this will probably be what most beginners will go to because the name is film grain. But the reality is, this is the least used method of creating film grain in Photoshop. So this basically allows you to add film grain. This intensity basically takes the film grain out of the light areas, and you can control how much that highlight area is. But if you turn that to zero, you just get film grain across your whole image, and this highlight area does nothing. And here you can only adjust the intensity of the grain. You cannot adjust the size of it, the color, or anything else. So that's the film grain effect. I would say this is my least used method. I don't think I've ever used this method to add film grain. All right, next we have camera raw. And in the camera raw, under effects, you have grain. Now this is probably the most intuitive tool for adding grain, because in addition to grain, you can also control the size of the grain. You can also control the roughness, which is really nice. So in terms of control, I would say that this is probably one of the best. Okay. Next, we have noise. And here we just go to add noise. Now, the nice thing about this is it actually creates color noise. So if you're doing color film, this would be the most realistic implementation of the film grain. The one problem with this is you don't have any control of the size, right? You have control of the amount, but that doesn't control the size of the grain. It only controls how strong it is. You can also control Gaussian versus uniform. I generally find Gaussian works better. And you can also turn off the color if you just want some black and white grain. For creating film grain, this has been my default method for many years. But for all three of these methods, I want to show you something that's going to help you a lot. So let's cancel out of this. You'll notice that on all of these three methods, I was working directly on the layer. Now, when you're doing compositing or pretty much anything in Photoshop, you're going to have a layer stack. And having an effect like the film grain that you can only apply on one layer, well, the problem with that is that kind of defeats the purpose of having a layer stack. So most methods that I just showed you, you can actually apply to a gray layer and then use your blending modes to put the grain on top of the image. So let's go ahead and make a new layer, and we'll call this film grain. And I'm going to go to Edit, Fill, and then fill this with 50% gray and hit OK. Now, if I put this on any of these overlay methods, except Hard Mix, you're going to see that it really has zero effect on the image. And that's because overlay works with anything that's lighter or darker than 50% neutral. So right now, this film grain layer is doing nothing. But the beauty of this is if I go in here, let's convert this to a smart object. If I go to Camera Raw, apply my same grain effects here. So let's just zoom in here and get the grain looking how I want it to look. So maybe something like this, hit OK. Well, now I have this as a layer. It's adding grain to my image, and I can always go in here and adjust the settings to my grain. If I wanted it to be stronger, maybe rougher, something like this, I could go here, and it's just going to do that to my image. And if I add layers under here, they're simply going to be affected by this film grain on top. So this is a great way to do film grain. In addition to using the camera raw, you can also use it with the noise. So let's go ahead and add some noise. And if we want color film grain, this would be the way to do it. So let's add maybe 30. The other thing when you're doing this noise, because it's like at an individual pixel level, you want to add a little bit of blur to this. And you can add more depending on how big your image is and also how big you want your film grain. So that's kind of allows you to control these things. Also, if I wanted the film grain to be much bigger, I can always just take my overlay layer and make it bigger, and it's going to make the film grain bigger. So these are all methods that you can use for film grain using this kind of gray trick. So here I've done it with the noise. I could even, using this film grain layer, do the artistic film grain method and add the film grain that way. So whatever method I use to add grain to my gray layer, it's going to apply it over the whole thing using blending modes. Using the, you know, the same logic there, what I can do is create a pattern that has film grain, such as this one here, which I did just creating noise and then blurring it and then adding some contrast. But because this is a pattern, I can adjust the scale of it. And by putting it on overlay or one of the other overlay methods, well, now I have film grain that I can control the size of right here by just pulling the slider up or down. So this is another way that you can add film grain to your image, and you can always adjust how strong the film grain is with your fill here, right? So as you move towards zero, there'll be no film grain, and as you move to 100, it'll be really strong. Also, if you want to just quickly make it lighter, soft light will just kind of kill it off. It's almost like overlay at 50%. And if you want it really strong, you can actually do hard mix and take the fill down to like 10. And that's about what an overlay would give you. But now you can also increase it beyond that and start to get an effect that's much stronger than overlay will give you. Now, pretty much anything beyond like 35 is going to be unusable. So when you're using hard mix for this kind of blending, you really want to keep it somewhere between 10 and 15. I would really recommend just using overlay or one of these other ones instead, unless you really want a strong film grain effect. But there you go. That's how you can add film grain. I actually created an action for myself that adds film grain. And it uses the method of creating a noise layer and then blurring it. And it just creates an overlay on top of the layer stack. This is part of my Nucly actions, which I'll include a link to in the description. So there you have it. That's how you add film grain in Photoshop non-destructively. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please subscribe to my channel. Leave a like, leave a comment, share this video. Here are some other videos to check out, and I will see you next time.